All right. Hello, everyone. This is Joe Marini. Welcome to another edition of Chrome Apps Office Hours. Today, I thought we would do something a little bit different. If you've been following along, you've probably noticed that Chrome packaged apps have been getting a lot of attention in the press lately. We recently turned on our initial rollout of Chrome packaged apps in the Chrome Web Store, if you were on the dev channel on Windows or Chrome OS, and so the press took notice. And as a result, we've been getting a lot of attention from some new developers who want to learn about what Chrome packaged apps are. So the last several shows we've done have been some relatively advanced topics, and I thought today I'd do something a little bit different and maybe do a little bit of a rewind and just do a quick intro of packaged apps and their structure for some of the newer developers out there. So if you have any questions of the stuff that I'm going to be showing you, go ahead and post them in the comments section of the tab there, and we will monitor the comments to see if there are any questions. Not a very long show today, so if you have any questions, please get them in, and we will get them answered. So let's just jump over to the diagrams here and show you a little bit about packaged apps and what their structure is. So packaged apps are built using HTML5, just like regular web apps are. So to do that, you just build your content as you normally would. You'd build your HTML, your CSS, you've got your JavaScript code, whatever other assets that comprise your app. You don't do anything really different. You just build your app normally. There's a few things you have to worry about. You can't do things like inline JavaScript, you know, like in your script tags. You can't use inline event handlers, things like that. But for the most part, you know, you just build the web app that you like just the way that you always would. Now, on top of that, packaged apps, you just simply layer some additional information on top of them. So for example, we ask you to put some infrastructure around your existing web code. We ask you to make a manifest.json file, and that's just a JSON code structure that defines the information that the platform needs. And there's something called a background HTML file and a JavaScript file. I've got it called main.js here, but you can call it pretty much whatever you want. So this infrastructure is what tells Chrome that this particular application is a packaged app and provides the necessary information for the runtime to be able to run the app and read its permissions and so on. So the manifest.json file, as I mentioned, it's a straightforward JSON structure. And in the JSON code, you do things like specify what the name of the app is, its version, what permissions it has, that kind of stuff. The main.js file is a little bit different. It simply defines the entry points into the application. So this is where you do things like register your event handlers and create windows and so on and so forth. All right, so now that we have an idea of what the structure of packaged apps looks like, let's get out of the slides here and jump over to some code. And if you want to follow along with me, I'm just looking at the code that's here on our Google Chrome GitHub repo. If you go to the Chrome-app-samples repo in our top-level Google Chrome folder there, you'll see what I'm talking about. I'm going to scroll on down here, and I'm going to open up the Hello World folder right here. And you can see inside this folder we've got some code. So I'm going to quickly open up the manifest.json file here so we can see what its contents are. And this is intended to be a really simple sample. So nothing too complex is going on here. You can see that it specifies a manifest version, and the current version of manifest files is 2. And there's a name of the app, which happens to be Hello World. This version field right here is for my purposes. This is the version of my app. And the Chrome Web Store uses this field to figure out what the newest version of your app is so that it knows when it's doing an update check for people who have your app installed, whether it needs to push out an update or not. I happen to have a minimum Chrome version specified here. So this is the minimum version of Chrome that the user has to have installed in order for this app to run. And there's an icon section, and down here is an app section. And in the app section, there's a field called background. And here in the scripts subfield, there's a main.js. Now, I happen to call the file main.js. You can call it whatever you want. And I would normally host this inside the background.html page, but that's actually optional. If you don't provide us one of those, we'll just simply auto-generate one for you. So you really only need the manifest and the JavaScript file, which handles the bootstrapping and other event handling of the app's infrastructure. All right, so that's the manifest file. Let's jump back out and take a look at the main.js file. And I'll scroll down the code here. Okay, so here in this JavaScript file, the application is adding a listener for the onLaunched event. The onLaunched event is on the Chrome app runtime space, and the callback function right here that's going to get called when the onLaunched event fires is simply checking to see how big the screen is and then deciding where to put the window it's about to create. And so it comes up with the width and the height. Those are just hard-coded. It uses the screen width and screen height to center the window on the page. So I call Chrome app, and then we have a window namespace right here, dot create. And that creates the window given the index.html page I'm going to use as the main window. And then I give it some properties. I give it some bounds. And you can see here that I'm using the screen width and height to figure out where the app is going to go. Now, to test this out, what you do as a developer is load up Chrome, so start Chrome, and then go to the Extensions tab in your Chrome settings. So down here, now I'm doing this on a Pixel, but this is, you know, easily, you can get to this page easily on any one of the platforms. So under Settings, I'm going to click on the Extensions tab. And here in the Extensions tab, you can see I've got Developer Mode turned on here in the upper right-hand corner. And once I turn Developer Mode on, I'll get these buttons, Load Unpacked Extension, Pack Extension, so on. So if you click on Load Unpacked Extension, you'll get a file dialog that lets you choose the application that you want to load to test. So I've loaded up Hello World right here. And there's a couple of ways I can launch this to test it. I can click on the little launch link right here, or I can go into my new tab experience. Right here, I've got my new tab, and I can scroll over to my installed apps. But because I'm on a Chrome OS device that's got the latest version of Chrome running, and I've got my launcher down here in the Chrome OS bar, my app just shows up here in the launcher once I've loaded it. And it shows up this way, whether I've loaded it unpacked or whether I've installed it from the Chrome Web Store. It's a really handy little feature to be able to load these unpacked folders of code while you're doing your iteration and testing. So I'll just go ahead and launch that app. And you can see that the window comes up, it's centered on the screen, and this is the Hello World example. So pretty straightforward example. Let's take a look at something that's a little bit more involved and actually requires some permissions. So let's go back to the samples on our GitHub. And this time I'm going to go over to the file system example. So right here in file system access, I'm going to click there. And we'll scroll down. Let's take a look at the manifest JSON for this one. All right, we'll scroll down a little bit. So you can see that this manifest file is slightly more advanced than the one for Hello World. The first properties are all pretty similar. They're pretty standard, actually. You give it a name and a version and the manifest version. Those are always there. And then down here, you can see I've got a permissions field right here, which is asking Chrome for the permission to use the file system. And in this case, we want to be able to write file data. And we also want to be able to retain entries. So the Chrome runtime lets you hold on to file entries that the user has previously opened in your application. And this comes in handy when you want to do things like implement a recently used file menu, for example. And we're also asking for access to the storage permission, so we can use our sandbox storage to store files. There's also a file handlers field. And this is where we associate file handler, mind types, and in this case, it's not using file extensions, but you can also specify 3 or 4 or whatever character file extensions so that when the user wants to open a file, either by double-clicking on it or right-clicking or whatever, the Chrome runtime knows that your app is one of the potential candidates for handling a file of that type. So slightly more advanced, in this case, it's actually asking for permissions. All right, so let's jump over to the documentation for all this. The documentation for Chrome packaged apps is on our developer.chrome.com/apps site, and that will take you to this welcome page right here. I'm going to click on this link for Understand the Architecture. So this page explains all about how the architecture of Chrome packaged apps works. It runs through the life cycle, what kinds of events there are, gives you a high-level overview. For more detailed information on things like the structure and APIs that are available to you as part of the overall lifecycle and architecture of your app, I'm going to scroll down here to the Chrome JavaScript APIs link. And let's fire up the app runtime docs. And you can see here that this is where the documentation for some of the various runtime related events are kept. So here's the one for the on launched listener. There's also one for on restarted. So if your app has been restarted because of an update or whatever. And you can see down here, there's also various sample apps that show how to use these events. So the Chrome runtime is the namespace you use for handling typical lifecycle events in your application. And this area of the documentation right here, actually, the Chrome APIs, this is where all of the JavaScript APIs that are specific to the Chrome platform are listed. So if you're a new developer, you need to understand this. We use HTML5 and related JavaScript APIs wherever they provide a feature that the platform needs. We don't try to invent new things or reinvent the wheel if we don't have to. We then create Chrome APIs that fill in various needs of the system where HTML5 doesn't provide a solution. For example, we have the ability to take advantage of Chrome's syncing architecture. If you've ever used Chrome on multiple computers and you're signed in, you'll notice that your bookmarks appear across various instances of Chrome. You, as a packaged app developer, can take advantage of that. Now, obviously, HTML5 doesn't have a feature for that. That's a Chrome feature. So we provide a Chrome API. So that's a quick introduction to the structure of packaged apps. I'm going to take a quick look over at the stream to see if there are any questions. Doesn't appear that there are. So if you do think of any, you can always find me. I'm Joe Marini on G+. I'm also on Twitter, Joe Marini. And you can always leave the comments here in the YouTube tab. We monitor the forums for questions. So please feel free to leave questions, and we'll respond to them as they come in. See you next time on Chrome Apps Office Hours for Packaged Apps. Hope you enjoyed the introduction to packaged app structure, all you new developers. So get out there and start building some great packaged apps.